everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about what's in my violin case. This is a video that I see pretty commonly on the violin internet, and I thought I would do one of my own, except this one is going to be very honest. I haven't even looked at what's in my case. I don't even know what I'm about to show you guys. For all you know, there's probably a bunch of junk in there. Who knows? But anyways, I'm gonna try to keep this as honest as possible and letting you guys know what I have in my violin case as a music major. So for starters, I am currently in a Peabody practice room because I have nowhere else to film this video. So let's start. As you can see here, I have a case, the Tonarelli brand. I got it from Amazon for about $200. I like it. I got it before college. This is relatively new. A few things I have to say about it. I really like the lightweight, which is why I bought it in the first place as opposed to the previous one I had, which could hold music. There is a pouch that you can buy to attach, but I haven't bought one and I don't use the pouch. I bought this for the lightweight, and the only complaint I have is that it doesn't really stay open. So let me show you what I mean. So first, I really like these clicky things, very easy to open, close, whatever. Once you open it, it has a tendency to like slam shut. And the number of times that my hand has been caught under that, trying to save my violin from getting crushed, can't even count. So yeah, there's a price for the lightweight. I don't know, I'm sure there's better quality cases out there, but this is what I have so far. As you can see, this is also a relatively new case. But so, when you first open the case, what you're gonna get is a nice view of this cloth. So in here I have two bows. This is my spare bow and this is the one I usually use. This spare bow is super old. I've had it since middle school. It's just like in case my main bow stops functioning or something. So I'm gonna open this. I have two cloths because this, the one that the case came with, I feel like is really thin and it doesn't do much. So I took the cloth from my other case, my old case, and I put it in here. Something worth noting is that I actually don't have a luggage tag yet. I don't know why, I've always had a luggage tag, but they're usually given to me for free by like whatever orchestra I'm a part of, and I haven't gotten one yet. I need to get on that, is what I'm saying. I need a luggage tag. But as of right now, I have this piece of paper right here that says my name on it and some contact information in case I lose it, which I haven't lost it yet because I keep this thing with me everywhere. I have my name in here as a temporary luggage tag while I get a luggage tag. This video is reminding me I'm gonna go order some from Amazon or get some as soon as possible. But yeah, another reason why I haven't really felt a need to get the luggage tag is probably because my case is purple and I have yet to see another purple case. So when you open up this case at first, right off the bat, you're gonna see I have a lot of cloths. I have three. One, two, three. And all of these were given to me for free. The one I have here is, it's not, I don't use this for wiping. It's like a microfiber cloth that you would probably use to clean your phone. See my case? It just doesn't stay open. But so what I actually have is this piece of cloth, right? I have it held onto the violin with a rubber band. So just to show you guys, I have this cloth that's usually held with just a rubber band. Just to protect the chin rest for when I'm playing, because I don't want my chin rest to get all sweaty, and if like I just worked out or something and I didn't have time to shower before I practice, I usually put this on. Or just like when I play, I don't really want sweat to get on my chin rest. That's just something I do that's particular. Right here you can see, I take my violin aside, I have a shoulder rest in here. The shoulder rest is held really securely under my violin, which is really nice. So then this pouch has things that I need. But going backwards just a bit, let me talk about what's on my violin. So two things on my violin is, you'll notice I have a clear mute. Nothing special about it, it's just clear. But it's just a mute for orchestral playing because sometimes they'll ask you to play with a sordino, which is this mute. And then I have this, which I've gotten some questions about. It is not a mic, that would be cool. But this is a humidifier. This is a dampit humidifier that you use usually during the winter time. Since I live in Georgia, it's pretty humid during the summer, I don't need it. But during the winter, anywhere, it gets really dry, right? So what you do is you take this dampit, you soak it in water, and then you just place it into the F hole of your violin, right here, like I had. And it's super nice because I have it in 24/7 and I'm able to play like there's no sound damage at all. Nothing is lost. Everything sounds perfectly fine. And so I really like this Dampit. I highly recommend. It just doesn't affect your playing at all and you can constantly have it in there and not worry about your instrument getting too dry. Let's move on to what is in this little pouch section. Moving on, this pouch comes with the case and it's really nice, although I broke the zipper on the first day. So if I open up this pouch, you can see I have some spare masks. I have a rosin, which I use this one. Some spare strings. I have not used these strings before, so I'm not sure how they are. I currently have on the Peter Enfeld strings, I believe. A pencil, because you always need a pencil for orchestra. I also have a practice mute in case I don't want to be loud to the people near me, like if I'm playing a hotel or something. I have earplugs in case my playing drives me crazy. I don't know, sometimes when I'm practicing really loud chords or high notes, I'll need these earplugs to take a break. So that's what's in this pocket section. Also, my hands are so dry. I'm so sorry, you guys. I promise I use lotion. I just hate getting it on my violin, so I always have to wash my hands. I wash my hands so many times a day, and that lotion does not have enough time to sink in, so my hands are super dry all the time. But anyways, I'm gonna show you guys a little secret no one asked for, but my rosin is in a state of distress constantly, okay? My rosin has broken so many times. It's literally held together by a rubber band. Like, it still works. I just keep it because I dropped it within like the first week of opening it, so I was really mad and decided that I would keep going with it. And it's lasted me another at least couple of months, and it's still lasting me, which I hope it lasts me for like years. So that's all I have to say about that. So that's all I'm gonna show inside my case. There's really nothing else to it. Oh, it comes with these straps that I strapped on so I could carry it like a backpack. But now let's move on to what's inside basically my violin bag, which is because I don't have the pouch that puts my music, I have to carry this tote bag around. I'm not complaining because I actually really like it. Well, basically, for starters, we just have a ton of music. That's what I keep in here, just loads of music, whatever I'm playing, orchestra repertoire, chamber music, etudes, scales, everything is in this tote bag. Next up, I have my iPad. The iPad is one of the greatest investments you can make as a musician because it'll save you from having to carry all these books around all the time. The only reason why I still carry them is because I haven't fully transitioned to my iPad. I still prefer paper copies, and if I already have them, I might as well use them. But for my iPad, it's really great because I can have essentially any sheet music that I want through IMSLP. I can just download it, have it on my iPad, organize them however, and play from my iPad, especially for like orchestra scores and things like that, or scores in general, piano scores, whatever. It's really easy to have an iPad so you don't have to print all this paper out for class or something. So I highly recommend. The only thing I would say is I got the 11-inch iPad and I really regret that. I should have gotten the 13-inch one because sometimes I do have trouble seeing the music and the bigger screen is much better. It's much more like the size of a violin book in general. Now finally what I have, and I brought the case too so you guys can see, this Donner Page Turner. I just bought it. I have not actually started using it yet. I set it up already, but basically it looks like this. It's really easy to carry around. It's a page turner that's hands-free for your iPad, Mac, or whatever you want to use, and it's really great for especially orchestra music or like when you're playing a solo in a recital. You put this on the ground and you just tap it with your feet, whichever way you want the music to go, up or down, scrolling left or right. There's a lot of functions here that I have yet to play with. It's a really great investment as well. I see a lot of people using it nowadays. Okay guys, thank you guys so much for watching what's in my violin case. I just wanted to give you guys like a brief tour of what I have with me every day as I go to rehearsals, lessons, class, whatever it is. Those are my essentials. As you can see, not everything has to be perfect. Sometimes life is chaotic. My luggage tag isn't there. I still can't believe that I just remembered I didn't even have that. My rosin is completely destroyed, but it still works. She's still there. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any questions about anything, let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in my next video.